I'm Assemblyman Tom Abinanti. I represent Westchester County, but I'm here today on behalf of a bill, Assembly Bill 3415A, sponsored in the Senate by Senator Thomas. And I'm here with my colleagues as representatives of the entire state of New York. We're not here talking about just a local bill. We're not just talking about a local problem. We in this state are very proud of the fact that we don't let anybody suffer without services, but that we provide a very robust Medicaid system for those people who can't help themselves, who don't have sufficient insurance, don't have sufficient resources, or who are with disabilities. You heard the governor yesterday talk about what a great system we have. And we often get criticized for having such a robust system because we provide so many services. But every once in a while, we find that the system doesn't cover some things that should be covered. And we're here today to talk about one of those situations. I'm not going to go into the specific circumstances. Chris Scheppa is here to talk about those, and I'm sure Senator Thomas will also talk about them, and we'll give my colleagues a chance to introduce themselves and to say something as well. But what this is about is a defect in our system. This is a situation where Medicaid is failing one young man, his family, his friends, all of the people who are concerned about him. And I'm sure that this is repeating all over the state. It's just that the people who are suffering are so overwhelmed, they haven't had the chance and the energy to come forward to their legislators and to say, hey, we want you to hear us, and we want to tell our story, and we want this fixed. What we're talking about here is a young man who needs 24-hour-a-day nursing services. And those services aren't always available. He's fortunate that his mother is a nurse and can provide those services. But when she provides those services, she doesn't get paid as a nurse. She's considered to be his mother. And so she's volunteering those services. And sometimes she can get paid at the rate of a family companion, which is $13 an hour, $18 an hour, $12 an hour. He has a approval for 24-hour-a-day nursing services, but can't get those services. And his mother, who fortunately is skilled, often has to stay home, basically just keep him alive. That points to me to three problems with our system. First of all, we're talking about a shortage in the Medicaid system of trained, available healthcare professionals who are willing to work in the Medicaid system. That's got to be fixed. Secondly, it points to a disturbing trend that the state is more and more looking to families to do what the state should be doing and shifting that responsibility to families. I'm not saying that families shouldn't pitch in. I'm not saying that families shouldn't help their loved ones. But there are certain things that families should not be called upon to do, which is to provide professional services for their own children. And why are we shifting this obligation? And it's happening everywhere, not just in this circumstance, but if you look at what's going on in the Medicaid system, what's going on in the DD system, the developmental disability system, what's going on with people with mental illness, more and more, we're asking for the families and others to step in. And lastly, it's a discrimination against people with disabilities. We're saying here that your family has a person with a disability. Too bad. You're going to have to take care of the problem. And if that means you have to leave your job and not get paid and not be able to support your family, that's your problem. And in this situation, we have a registered nurse who could go and provide the very services that her son needs to someone else and get paid, but is told, no, you're not going to get paid for providing it to someone who fits the category who you can help. Why? Because you're a family member. Well, that's discriminating against family members of people with disabilities. And it's an attitude that we've got to change and say we're not going to discriminate against people with disabilities anymore in this state. So this is about a young man named Scheppa, but it's also about the policies of the state of New York that we have to change. Otherwise, we forfeit the proud statement that we make that we take care of everybody, we care about everybody in New York, and we're the most progressive state. We've got to make sure that we live up to that mantra. And here's a perfect example of where we're not. So at this point, I'd like to introduce Senator Thomas, who stepped forward.
Thank you.
To carry the bill in the Senate.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Senator Kevin Thomas, and I represent Garden City. And my constituent reached out to me when I first took office last year. Christine Scheppa, please come up here when I'm talking about this. She is a warrior. She's a very brave woman to basically go out there and fight for her child, not just for him, but she's doing this for everyone in New York State. In 2016, Christine's life changed forever when her son, Vinny, was injured in a skateboarding accident. As a registered nurse, Christine should have the right to provide care to her son and be compensated fairly. Instead, Chris spends 48 plus hours a week working three different nursing jobs just to be able to spend more time with Vinny. She struggles to find nurses that can provide the same level of care for her son, all while providing that same care for strangers at various hospitals across Nassau County. And Chris is not alone. So many families across our state have to sacrifice so much just to care for their own family members. I cannot imagine the struggles and sacrifices that people like Chris have made, but as a father, I recognize and understand her pain and her deep love for her son. We need a change. Our caregivers and loved ones deserve so much better than this. The Vinny Scheppa law will ease the burden on caregivers and families by allowing registered nurses to care for their loved ones and receive just compensation. Passing this law is just the right thing to do. I will continue to fight for Chris and other families across our state, and that is why I am here today. If you look back to last session, this was passed from the Senate. So I am urging all my friends in the Assembly to please make this a priority, and let's have the governor sign this into law. I believe this passed after the budget last year, so there were these fiscal implications. Now that we are here, let's fight for this in the budget, if possible, and get this through. She deserves it, and every mom and every parent out there that has a child like this deserves to have something like this in law. All right? With that, let me give you Chris Scheppa.
Thank you. Good morning. As you all know, my name is Chris Scheppa, and I'd like to thank everyone for coming here today. Without everyone's hard work and dedication, we would not be here. I would like to thank my families, friends, community, especially the Senator, Senator Thomas, Legislator Albanati. I'd like to thank you so much for your hard work and addressing the needs of people who require 24/7 nursing care. We're here today to advocate for the Vincent Scheppa bill, also known as Bill A03415 in the Assembly. For those of you that are unfamiliar with this bill will act as a mechanism to allow a parent whom is a registered nurse to be able to provide services in the home to their child that has been approved private duty nursing hours and being reimbursed at a nursing rate. Tragedy defined is an event causing great suffering, destruction and distress, such as a serious accident. Tragedy can affect any one of us, any given moment. It takes us by surprise. And although we have no control over tragedy, tragedy holds up a mirror to a broken system. My son Vincent had a tragic accident and suffered a traumatic brain injury. Traumatic brain injury includes any insult to the brain, and examples include trauma to the head, a stroke, could be an infection, oxygen deprivation. The Brain Injury Association of New York findings show that every 13 seconds, someone in the United States sustains a traumatic brain injury. So because of Vincent's brain injury, he remains in a minimally conscious state and requires 24/7 nursing care. Vincent's tragedy is something that I have come to accept. However, what I cannot accept is the failure of the state of New York to address the current needs of patients that require private duty nursing services at home. According to the Affordable Care Act, individuals that receive private duty nursing services through Medicaid assistance are entitled to payment of services as well as the actual services themselves. Okay? Allowing a parent who is a registered nurse to get paid and take care of their own family members is common practice in many other states. Unfortunately, the state of New York prohibits this practice. The Vincent Scheppa bill provides a solution to the current nursing shortage of home care nursing. This bill has no fiscal impact. This bill will help to expand the availability of nurses in the workforce for the home care population. The life of Vincent depends on nurses showing up to work. If a nurse does not show up, then I cannot go to work, hindering my ability to provide for my family. This runs the risk of Vincent having to be institutionalized. Allowing a parent who is a registered nurse the opportunity to provide the care, be reimbursed, and keep their loved one home will benefit the state as well as the patient. As society, we have an ethical responsibility to care for others, and these include people who require 24/7 skilled nursing care. These people are our children, our parents, siblings, our grandparents, and our families deserve the right to dignity, respect, safe care, quality of life, and the right to remain in their own home. So we stand before you today to advocate for this bill and offer a viable solution to the problem. Thank you very much. Tim?
I think there are some points that are worth stressing. Number one, this young man has already been authorized to have these services. The state of New York has said, yes, you need these services. We will pay for them. Number two, this is a much less expensive alternative to a nursing home. This young man and this mother, by doing what she's doing, is saving the state money. Makes no sense from the point of view of the state to not assist and make sure that there is nursing care there all of the time, that he gets the proper care, and they pay her when someone else can't show up. And we're talking here about, you know, we talk a lot about dignity, we talk about a lot about how we care about people. Well, this is not honoring that commitment. This is not making sure that this man continues to live in dignity. It's forcing the entire family to scramble, to rely on others who should not have to be part of this whole thing. It is putting a burden on them that they should not have to bear. I want to introduce Tim O'Hanlon, who's Chris Shepard's, who is he here?
Tim's right there. Yeah. He's a student at Garden City High School.
Come on up, Tim. Introduce yourself. Tell us who you are.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Timmy O'Hanlon, and I'm a junior at Garden City High School, the same school where Vinny attended. I am honored to speak to you all here today to represent his alma mater. I helped collect nearly 300 signatures from students, teachers, and members of the community on a petition supporting this bill. For those of us close to Vinny's age, an accident like his is scary. In a single moment, Vinny's life changed forever, and so did his mother's. When students stopped to think about this, several things repeatedly came up in conversation. Many students questioned why Vinny's mother couldn't take care of Vinny all the time, and they all agreed that they would only want their mother or a close loved one to take care of them. We're not just talking about a temporary stay in a hospital where different nurses might take care for us. We're talking about the rest of Vinny's life. On behalf of the students at Garden City High School, I urge the New York State Assembly to pass this bill patients who require the 24-hour care that Vinny does deserve this. Mrs. Scheppa deserves this, and Vinny deserves this. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. There's hope for the future with that kind of generation.
My district.
I have five colleagues here. I'm going to let them introduce themselves and speak one at a time. You guys figure out the order. Who's senior here? Do you want to do seniority, or you want to go next?
Thank you, Tom. I'm Assemblyman Ed Rye. I represent the 19th Assembly District. I just want to thank Senator Thomas for taking up this cause since he came into office last year. And, you know, this has been passed through the Senate a number of times now. I had called Tom Abernathy a few years ago because I know that he is second to none in the New York State Assembly when it comes to advocating for the voiceless. The only other person that's on his level is also standing to my right here. That's Missy Miller. And, you know, Tom took up the bill as his own. We've gotten it through health the last couple of years, and we need to clear that last hurdle, get through Ways and Means. Ideally, get it in the budget and do what's right for not just this family, but families throughout the state who are dealing with this type of issue. It's a no-brainer. It's not a fiscal impact on the state, and it's the right thing to do. And lastly, I want to thank Chris Scheppa for her advocacy, and Tim as well, who I had the opportunity to meet with another classmate of his at Garden City High School last year, and they've taken up this cause and advocating for it. And yeah, as was said, our future's bright. You're already a pro up here at the podium. So great work. Thank you to all my colleagues for being here. And let's make this the year that that we pass this into law. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Missy Miller. I am a mom, like Chris, of a child who needs 24-hour nursing, has been authorized for 24-hour nursing, and also cannot get any. We have a nurse 3 days a week. Many people who are here will see, they're very used to seeing my son Oliver because he has to come with me up to Albany, and I'm from Long Island as well. And I bring him up here because I don't have a nurse. So as Assemblyman Abernathy said, this is it's a huge problem in our Medicaid program that there are not enough nurses who are willing to work in the home care environment, especially the skilled care nurses, because they don't pay enough. They're not competitive with hospital rates. There are no benefits with most of these agencies, and it's something that really desperately needs to be fixed, especially as the shift has gone from in-house care or, you know, residential care to home care environments. We don't have the supports that are necessary in the actual home care environments. I myself am not an RN, so I am doing skills that I learned on my son. I wasn't trained formally to do any of the stuff that I'm doing, IV infusions, all kinds of very skilled medical care. But again, anybody who is should be able to be compensated for that care the same way another nurse would be compensated. The other thing that people miss out on is that she's already running around working three jobs. If somebody cancels, she can't go earn what her family needs her to be earning because she's forced to stay at home to take care of Vinny at the much lesser rate than she would be able to earn were she able to just go out and do this, you know, for at the hospitals. So it's truly, truly something that needs to be fixed. And this is one step that will at least allow fair compensation for the skilled care that, you know, she is providing. I hear all the time from other members, from people up here, have you looked at this place? Have you looked at this place? We want our kids home. We want to be taking care of them. But we need the supports that this state says it provides. It's time to back it up. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Joe DeStefano. I represent the 3rd Assembly District out in Suffolk County. As the father of a registered nurse, I can absolutely sympathize with Mrs. Scheppa regarding this issue. My daughter used to work in the home care field until she couldn't afford to work there anymore. And she went to go work in a hospital where the pay was a lot better. One of the things that, listening to everybody speaking here this morning, is that one of the hardest things you have to do is get approved for these types of services. The hard part is over. Now it's time to pay for it. And I think that, you know, it's a really, like Assemblyman Ross said, it's going to be much less expensive to have them stay in the homes where the rehabilitation is more comfortable than it is in a facility where, you know, you don't know what you're going to get. And we should have this bipartisan. This is not something that is one side or the other. When these are those kinds of bills where you say, you know something, it makes a lot of sense. And we're all about making the lives better of the New Yorkers that we represent. So I'm in favor of this. I will be supporting this. And I hope that my colleagues do as well. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Dave McDonough. I represent the 14th Assembly District just south of Garden City. But this is statewide. And you said it, Tim. You said it very well. This is one of your colleagues, one of your classmates, and all of that stuff. And I can't do anything more than what they've said before. It's unbelievable. What Chris, what you're doing, my friend Missy, what she's doing, you got to see this woman. She's with her son every year, every week, up here with her, with him. So this has got my support. Senator Thomas, I agree with you. Thank you for what you're doing. And my colleague, Ms. Abernathy, you're good. Thank you. So. I like you anyway. I do. Stand up. Oh, I'm sorry. You are standing, right?
Don't say you like me too loud. You're in the other political party.
We make that joke on the floor a lot. But I am 100% for this, and I will do everything I can to help get it passed. And it's a common sense measure. That's all that is, common sense. So, Chris, good luck. We're going to do it.
I promise I won't make any short jokes at all.
Missy Miller thinks I'm very tall.
I'm Mary Beth Walsh. I represent the 112th Assembly District, which is near here, parts of Saratoga and Schenectady County. And everybody's pretty much said anything that I would want to say. The only thing that I want to touch on is what Mr. Abernathy was talking about at the very beginning, which is the exhaustion of many families who have family members who have lifelong disabling injury. I'm so impressed that Chris has done what she's done, and I know that she's got a team of people here supporting her, but that ability to have so much in terms of directly caring for your loved one, but still having enough strength and energy to go and work those three jobs and still be advocating for this bill. That's why I'm so glad that I have my colleagues here. We're here to do our jobs and try to get this bill over the finish line. It's really time. It makes a lot of sense. As my other colleagues said, it is bipartisan. And I think that we owe it. We owe it to these families to make this happen and to do it. So I'm going to certainly do my job. I know we all are standing here to do the same. And hopefully, we're starting early now this year in January, so we're hopeful that we're going to get this done this year. So thank you.
What I didn't say in the beginning was I am a parent of a child with autism, and I've seen what it's like to try to make sure that there's somebody there all of the time with him. But fortunately, he's pretty self-sufficient. He doesn't have the judgment to be able to be alone, but he can do most things for himself. And that's nowhere near what they're talking about, but I did have an experience earlier when I first married my wife. She had a child with CP, and he didn't need nursing services all of the time. But I saw how difficult it was to just get somebody there when we weren't there. And how she had to learn to do all kinds of things. She's a teacher, not a nurse, not in the healthcare field. And so she had to provide all kinds of services because the system wasn't able to provide the specialists. All they could do was give us a home care worker. And even trying to get a home care worker there all of the time was a fight and was a problem. So I can't imagine what it's like. When the life of your child is dependent on somebody showing up. Not just the well-being, but the life of that child is dependent on somebody showing up. We've got to change this. We've got to change the attitude of the state of New York to make sure that we actually do what we're saying we're doing, which is taking care of New Yorkers. Thank you for all coming.